So there's this new internet challenge called the Invisible Box Challenge. And the idea is that there is this invisible box on the ground that you put your foot onto it and you kind of walk over it. It's pretty cool though. Now Janik was saying to me that he was pro at this trick, so let's check it out. Janik, are you ready?
I'm ready.
He's going to do the Invisible Box Challenge like a pro. Alright guys, let's check it out.
Jordy, look what I can do!
What up guys, Jordy here for Cinecom.net and welcome to the first copycat of 2018. Now this is the first of 52 episodes where we break down the effect or technique from a popular film or music clip. Now today we'll be having a look at the Invisible Box Challenge. A new internet hype that is for once not stupid like the cinnamon or choking challenges we had before. In fact, I love the Invisible Box Challenge. Invisible Box Challenge. There's a real box right here, but it's invisible. It's not so easy though, and that's why we sheet it with some editing tricks. And here's how we did it. First of all, the filming. To make it a little bit more realistic, you want to walk around with your camera handheld. Film your subject in an empty space. This is exactly what magicians do too. They might say that there's nothing up their sleeves, but in reality, they're just making you confused. Now while you are filming your subject, you also want to point your camera to someone or something else. I pointed it to myself as it seems like I was talking to the camera. But that was all put in scene to cover up the magic, because I needed a swipe back to my subject. After that swipe, I put my camera into a tripod. This right here is the Benro Aereo 7, which is a great tripod and we actually have a dedicated video about it, which you can find the link to in the description below. Now with having my camera on the tripod, I also make that same swipe movement again to Janik, who is wearing an awesome jacket. And now the magic trick begins. Janik has to stay on his point, so I am laying some bricks in front of him in the form of a little stair. Then I move back out of the frame and let the camera roll while Janik performs his magic walk. Now don't touch the camera yet. Keep it rolling while you move everything away out of your frame. You want to have an empty shot as well, which we're going to need inside Premiere Pro. Hey guys, I want to take a brief moment to talk about our brand new class on Skillshare, which is Adobe Premiere Pro 2018 for beginners. It's the fifth generation Adobe Premiere Pro class that we have created, and that means that we have tweaked it so much that it gives you the best learning curve to start editing with Adobe Premiere Pro. And the reactions that we've been getting so far has been amazing. Even Skillshare featured this class under the creative category, so that definitely means something. And by the way guys, if you sign up through Skillshare by following the first link in the description below, you can actually get the first 3 months for only 99 cents. And by that, you not only have access to our class, but also to all the other classes on Skillshare as well. And by the way, we also have a DSLR course and a Lumetri color grading course on Skillshare as well. So definitely make sure to check that out. Now let's take all the great footage that we've just shot and swing that into Adobe Premiere Pro. We have a shot of me talking to the camera, which swipes away. A pure transition shot on the tripod, a shot of Janik walking up to the bricks, and a completely empty shot. We'll first drag the clip of Janik to video channel 2. With the clip selected, I head over to the opacity property and click on the pen tool to create a mask. Around the bricks, I then draw a mask, and first you can do this very rough. Once your mask is done, you want to go into the settings and decrease the feather to around 5. Also enable inverted, which will leave a black hole where the bricks were. And now what I'll do is drag the empty shot onto video layer 1, and this layer will reveal itself through that hole, but because the bottom layer is exactly the same, but empty, it seems like we've magically poofed away the bricks. Now we've drawn that mask roughly, meaning we'll see it overlapping with Janik's foot. So the next thing we'll have to do is animate the mask path. Enable the animation toggle for that property, which will create a keyframe. Then adjust your mask over time so that it flows with the movement of Janik's foot. And this is something you have to do because we've been filming from above, meaning we have some perspective. Now once that is done, your magic trick should already work. But some people might not believe you because of the shadows down here. We're using an empty space to fill in the mask, which didn't have any shadows.
Jordy, look what I can do!
Okay, now we're just exaggerating, Janik. To bring back the shadows, I first want to clean out the heart mask, which we created first. For that, I take the empty shot and place it on layer 3. I click on the circle under the opacity to create a round mask. You want to change its position and size to cover up where the bricks were. Then from the mask properties, increase the feather, which is going to make that first mask less visible. Then for the last step, I'm placing Janek's clip on channel number 4. Here I also navigate to the opacity property and click on the circle mask. And this one I'll reposition underneath the shadow of the bricks. And this means that we're not showing the shadow of the bricks, only the shadow of Janek walking over those bricks. And that's all there is to it! The final steps are to match this shot with the previous handheld shot. So I'm going to select everything in my timeline, right click and choose nest. And this will group all of those layers together. Before that clip, I insert my shot where I was talking to the camera. I trim this clip right on the point where I'm fastly swiping my camera. Then I cut to the shot we took of swiping on the tripod. This is just a small piece, but will connect the two shots around it. And looking at the result, it somehow works, but not exactly. We went from a handheld shot to an instant tripod shot. So what I'll do next is head into my effects library and navigate to the fake handheld movement folder. This is actually a preset pack that we've created ourselves. It's free and you can find a download link to it in the description below. Now drag any type of handheld motion you want onto the nested sequence. Now this already looks a lot better, but there's one last thing missing. We're still going too sudden from a swipe to the tripod shot. So I'm going to go into the effects controls, locate the transform effect which has been applied through the preset. I'm moving the clip to the left through the anchor point property of that effect. I create a keyframe for that value in the beginning of the clip, and then I move a couple of frames forward and move the position of the clips through the anchor point to the other side of the canvas. One more time, a couple of frames forward, and now I reset the anchor point value, which will automatically create a keyframe. This adds a little bump into the shot, making that swipe appear more natural. And that, my friends, is how you can impress your friends with the Ultimate Invisible Box Challenge. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to see us every week, make sure to hit that subscribe button down below. But now it's time to go inside, because it is cold outside. And by the way, stay creative. And Janek, where have you put that invisible box? Seriously, dude, it's not funny if I will trip over it. Where have you put it? Janek, seriously, dude, come on. See, I tripped over it. What are these bricks for you, by the way? Now, where is that invisible box?